Welcome to the fifth video in Copilot for Security Flight School series. I'm Ryan Munch, your flight instructor. If you're watching this video, we're going to assume you've watched the prior four lessons and you have an instance of Copilot for Security ready to go. If you don't have Copilot ready, head over to MS Learn to begin your flight checks. As with the last video, we will spend most of the time in the platform walking through how to become an ace at Copilot for Security. In this lesson, we'll focus exclusively on plugins. Plugins, as we talked about with AI orchestration and our phishing example, extend the capabilities of Microsoft Copilot for Security by retrieving real-time information to allow users to interact with that information in a natural way. Copilot uses different sources enabled through plugins such as Microsoft's own security products, partners, open source intelligence feeds, and websites to create guidance that's customized to your organization. Microsoft plugins give Copilot access to information and capabilities from within your organization's licensed Microsoft products based on the permissions of the user. Using the standalone platform, you can see your system capabilities supported by the enabled plugins. By going to the prompt bar, clicking the prompts button, and then selecting See All System Capabilities. The results are the list of all the available system capabilities available to you based on the plugins you have enabled. You can also search to then get a corresponding list of skills for a specific plugin or prompt book. But what happens if you want to connect with data that is outside of Microsoft products? This is where our third-party plugins come into play. We categorize these plugins as either other, website, and custom. Most people starting out in Copilot will use the other and website plugins, and that is what we'll focus on in this segment. But if you're interested in custom plugins, go to the Extending Copilot for Your Ecosystem video later in this Flight School series. Partner plugins give Copilot for Security access to information and capabilities from services beyond Microsoft that your organization uses. You will need the appropriate licenses and authentication to use these features. Let's walk through this with a plugin for Tanium. We'll start by configuring the plugin. Plugin settings, whether built by Microsoft, a partner, or by your organization, can require settings for operation. In most cases, it is some type of authentication. For this plugin, it's basic, or in others, it can be elements required for operation. For Tanium, we need to specify the instance URL and our access key. With the plugin now enabled, I can check the provided skills in the suggested prompts to understand its operation, then begin prompting against it. We will begin our investigation by asking Copilot for information on a CVE, then assessing the impact against endpoints in our environment. I'll get a return of the affected endpoints. We'll pause our investigation here, but we can always pick it up later. The next plugin type to cover are the website plugins, which give Copilot for Security access to industry information from the public web. Currently, only the public web plugin is supported, but additional website plugins are expected. The website plugins are accessed using anonymous authentication. The final plugin type is the custom plugin, which extends Copilot to bring together insights and data from a specified system. The manifest can either be something from OpenAI or the Copilot standard. The manifests support three different types: KQL, API, and GPT. Those details, how to make custom plugins, and more we'll cover later in Flight School. Plugin management is a centrally controlled permission dictated by the owner of the Copilot for Security instance. Owners have two options for establishing access to custom plugins. The first option permits individual contributors the ability to control their own custom Copilot experience. If the option is set to owner, then only owners can add custom plugins to Copilot. The second option controls management, or whether contributors can upload custom plugins for their fellow colleagues to use. As a reminder, it is important to note the distinction between authentication types used by Microsoft products and those of custom plugins. For Microsoft products, on behalf of authentication is leveraged by the user to access individual systems, whereas custom plugin authentication is controlled by the plugin design and entered by the user. Therefore, it's recommended that owners retain management of plugins during initial rollout of Copilot. That's a great start to the world of plugins, and there will be plenty more about them in later Flight School episodes. With our plugin set, we'll be ready to begin prompting in our next episode of Flight School. Pick out your best bomber jacket and bring it along with you for our next lesson. I'm Ryan Munch, and I'll catch you next time, pilots.